is going on YouTube? This is Shadow Pony with yet another episode of the Brony Guide for you. Now, this episode is actually kind of special because, one, this is a video review of Equestria Girls Rainbow Rocks, which premiered today. And second, this video is actually being presented to you in 4K. I've been wanting to do 4K for a while, so I figured this would be the video that I do it with. Anywho, let's get to Rainbow Rocks. So, as many of you may remember, the first Equestria Girls movie premiered last year. It debuted a brand new chapter in the My Little Pony universe, where the main characters actually are in our world. And quite frankly, it's pretty freaking awesome. Now, when I saw the first Equestria Girls movie, I went in with low expectations. I didn't really know what to think, and I wasn't quite sure how well it was going to perform, how well it was going to stack up against the show. I did the same thing with Rainbow Rocks. And as with the first Equestria Girls movie, I was blown away. The storytelling in Rainbow Rocks is actually, I want to say, better than the first Equestria Girls movie. The animation is better, and I think that's all due in part because of season 4. We got to see much better flash animation. The villains are much better than in the original Equestria Girls. In fact, I dare say that the villains, known as the Dazzlings, who are as follows: Adagio, Sonata, and Aria. I can't quite remember their last names, so they are actually better than Sunset Shimmer was. In fact, I'm going to go as far as say they were better than Queen Chrysalis and King Sombra. Quite possibly Discord. They might actually be contenders for Discord. I don't know. All I know is that they're not as good as T-Rex. And they are much better than Nightmare Moon. But I think that's mostly because Nightmare Moon was the first villain, so the building blocks sort of. Anyways, what can you expect to see from Equestria Girls Rainbow Rocks? Well, as I said before, better animation, better storytelling, better villains. But there's more to it than that. Now, before I go further, if you are planning on buying Equestria Girls on DVD or Blu-ray, I suggest that you re-watch the first Equestria Girls, as well as all 4 seasons. Not just because it's fun, but because Rainbow Rocks actually references the first Equestria Girls movie. And seasons 3 and season 4. So you can probably skip seasons 1 and 2, but I wouldn't, because it's just fun watching all the episodes in a row, as it should be done. Anyways, the reason why I say that is because we do get to see some characters that only appear in season 4. I'm not gonna name names. Odd. We do get to see some fan favorites, Who do we get to see? Well, we get to see Trixie! Always fun. And she actually has a much, much bigger part in Rainbow Rocks than she did in the first Equestria Girls movie. In fact, Trixie actually has her own song. And for those of you that actually purchased the soundtrack, either on iTunes or Google Play or whatever, you will know that she has her own song, which is actually one of my favorite songs in the whole movie. Now, who else do we get to see? Well, we get to see Lyra and Bon Bon. We get to see Octavia, who actually has a speaking part. We get to see more Derpy, and she's actually front row center. She doesn't get a speaking part, and that is mostly because of last roundup. We all know that little fiasco, and I know Derpy will never actually get a speaking role because of that, but she is placed front row center. And, well, no surprise here. For those of you who have seen the Hasbro shorts, yeah, the little short animations that Hasbro put out over the past couple months leading up to Rainbow Rocks, you will remember that Vinyl Scratch, aka DJ Pwn 3, actually has a part in the film. Yeah, just as she had her own first short, well, her own little short animation, which was the first, she actually has her very own part. She doesn't speak, but it is substantial, and it is big enough. Now, let's move on to the storytelling. How does it compare to the show? How does it compare to the first Equestria Girls? Well, it is just as good as the show. What am I saying? It is actually as good as the show. And the story, the main story, is actually better than the first Equestria Girls. Why? Because the songs in the film actually play key parts. They're not just inserted at little moments where, you know, the story couldn't really pick up any momentum. So, yeah, the story will pick up, level off with the song, pick up some more momentum, then level off. Anyways, that's not what happens here. The songs are a big part of the film. And yeah. Now, characters. What about character development? What do we see there? Well, obviously, the main six haven't changed all that much from the show. They're still growing. Twilight is still growing. In fact, we actually see her picking up where... Well, we actually see her picking up where she gets her official title. And it's actually very interesting because she doesn't know what to do. It's a bit like Lesson Zero. She can't really force things to happen. And she still hasn't figured that out. She thinks that she has all the answers, but she doesn't. And I'm just going to leave it at that because there's a lot of spoilers in. I'm going to leave the characterization alone, but typically the characters act as we would expect them to act. But the biggest character development that we see actually comes from Sunset Shimmer. No surprise there. Sunset Shimmer has actually developed so much since we saw her at the end of the first Equestria Girls movie that it is phenomenal. I actually like Sunset Shimmer better as a protagonist than an antagonist. Why? Because she's not your typical high school bully in this one. She's actually trying to help people and to undo all the wrongs that she has done. Which we see with Discord. He tries to undo all the wrongs that he has done, and yeah, we end up loving him. We ended up loving Discord more as a good guy than we did a villain. And that's what happens with Sunset Shimmer. I like her more than I like her more in the I like her more than I did in the first Equestria Girls movie. I'm stammering. I'm stuttering. Sorry. I'm very sorry about this. Let's move on to the animation. What is the animation like? Well, all throughout season 4, we saw a major development in the animation. We saw shadowing. We saw lens flares. We saw all kinds of stuff. Do we see this in Rainbow Rocks? Yes, we do, actually. The shadowing is phenomenal. There are scenes where they are meant to be dark and dreary, and there is mist all over the floor. This green mist, just all over the floor. The characters that are within this sort of green mist or fog, or whatever you want to call it, is amazing. When we see Adagio, Sonata, and Aria all performing up on stage, we actually see a huge lens flare in one single scene where it just envelops them. And it is amazing. Now, the climax, how does that compare? Well, it's jaw-dropping, it's epic. The very first review for Equestria Girls that I read actually stated that Equestria Girls is basically a high school drama, but however, at the very end, children may be frightened because of a large monster that appears, which, as we all know, is Sunset Shimmer. Yeah, and in just like that, the fight's over. Yeah, taste the rainbow, bitch. That sort of thing. Is that the climax that we get with Rainbow Rocks? No, it is not. The climax that we get is actually on an epic level. The fact that they are actually fighting in the song, and the song that we get on the soundtrack, as compared to the song that is in the movie, is very different. So much so that the middle sequence was actually removed from the song on the soundtrack. Why? Because the change, it goes from typical villainy to just straight up hardcore heavy metal. Yeah, I don't know if any of you listen to Disturbed, but or even just classic Metallica. But that's what it goes to. It's like something that Eddie Van Halen would just say, okay, we're gonna put this in. Well, okay, maybe not Eddie Van Halen. Axl Rose from Guns N' Roses. But it is just epic. In fact, as it should be, the climax is one of my favorite scenes in the entire movie. Now, this is a bit of a spoiler alert, but the sequence that we actually hear, where in the soundtrack, You can't really tell because obviously Sunset Shimmer and Twilight Sparkle, they both have the same singing voice because they're both the same voice actors. However, Sunset Shimmer does actually sing in the climax, and it's awesome. It really and truly is awesome. So, even though I know all of you out there cannot see Equestria Girls in theaters, because as far as I know, today was the only day that it could be seen in theaters. Yes, September 27th, 2014. Yeah. It's probably never going to be in theaters again, but I do recommend that you pick it up on Blu-ray or DVD, or when it comes out on Netflix or TV, whenever you guys get a chance to see it, watch it, because it is phenomenal. It is excellent. It is, I got nothing. I cannot describe this. Now, granted, I am not a professional reviewer by any means, but, and this is just strictly from a fan's perspective, but it is awesome. I would not travel 2 hours by bus in the most uncomfortable seats on the planet to see this movie if I did not think that it was going to be good. Well, that and, you know, we haven't had any My Little Pony content actually from Hasbro since March? End of March? Let's say that. So, yeah. Anywho, I do highly recommend that you see it on Blu-ray and DVD when it comes out, or on TV, or on Netflix, or however you plan on seeing it. Who knows? But I do highly recommend that you watch it. Better yet, watch it with a friend. When I went and saw it, there was actually more bronies in the theater than there were little girls. In fact, there were actually two. Just two little girls. The rest of it was all bronies. So, watch it with a friend. Because you will laugh, you will have a good time. It won't be as awkward as Equestria Girls was. The first Equestria Girls, anyways. So, do I have any more to say? What more do I have to say? Oh. Oh. For those of you who have not seen an Equestria Girls movie in theaters, you might actually get a chance to. And I am just going to leave it at that. So, until next time, this is Shadow Pony